We have crossed the border into Belgium. For some reason, we expected something to be at the border, but it's just you drive over. So welcome to the continent. Thank you, Europe. And now we are in Ypres, I think, similar, something like that. Apparently, the English used to call it Wipers, because that was easier during World War II. There's a few places like that around here. But yeah, we're going to head into town and see what's in store. Mia's prepared a little tour. We're just going to grab some couscous and then we're on our way.
We have found ourselves in Ypres, and I've created a little mystery tour for Rob to check out because I enjoyed that so much when he did that for me in France. And on the mystery tour, we've discovered that lots of the monuments are currently under reconstruction. So there's lots of scaffolding, but we did find a nice park and an awesome river and some monuments to, guess what? The wars! This is war countries. It's so historical here. But the park's nice.
Yeah, really pretty, really peaceful. And we're sort of early moments in our discovery of this city, so, I mean, so far the architecture is wow.
Belgium does not disappoint.
Really, really pretty.
Could not recommend it more. We'll try and get some to show you guys. Just came down some spooky steps, and I think it says something like, this is the way the Western Front would, this is the way that the people on the Western Front would have used. It's super creepy, but we've come out into the daylight now. That's the hole we just came out of, and we're going to continue our walk along the river, but on like a more ground level. But there's a lot of history here, isn't there, Robbie?
Yes.
Architecture in Ypres was absolutely stunning, and we even went into the Ypres Museum. Here they give you cat paw print bracelets to activate different activities. It would be fantastic for parents with young children because it was super interactive.
Set off early this morning from our park up to get close to Bruges. We're basically as close to the city as we can without there being a sort of parking limit. In Belgium you get these sort of blue parking, I think it's called, which are like time limited sections, and we want to be in Bruges all day, so we are about 20 minutes out from the city, so we're going to go walking in now. And then I suspect we'll be entertaining ourselves in Bruges pretty much all day. There's a long list of things that we can do there, being, you know, sort of culture capital of Belgium and well known across Europe as a place for tourists to entertain themselves. So I'm really looking forward to it. Said to me last night, this is sort of one of my highlight destinations, not in least because of the film in Bruges, but because I've been so close to getting here before, because of unlikely circumstances, a fire on a train, I didn't make it. So really looking forward to today. We're just heading off now. So far has been beautiful in every way. Like, wherever you look, it's stunning. So we've discovered that if you walk down a street and think this looks pretty, you turn around and you're like, whoa, it's pretty behind you as well. But so much so that there are parts of Bruges which are empty and quiet and unlooked at, which in another city would probably have like a little point on Google Maps saying must see tourist destination, you've got to come here for a photo opportunity. It's really just grandiose in its beauty everywhere. It's genuinely overwhelming. Genuinely, hashtag the pub. Way better than the name suggests. They had like 80 Belgian beers here.
I have discovered a love for beer. Before Belgium, I did not like beer at all. Okay. But if you are like me, you've got to try the fruit beer. So yeah. A cherry beer, dark fruits beer. There was a framboise beer, which is raspberries, if you're like me and didn't know what that was. Yeah.
Until 3 days ago, I couldn't get Mia to drink more than a sip of my beer and go, your beer face, there it is. And now 3 days ago we discovered that by putting fruit in beer, which they love to do in Belgium, Mia's all on board. So fruity beers, let's go. Officially Bruged out. We're back at the van. We've basically had a lovely evening where we've followed the beer.
we've sauntered back via some chips. Mia's eyes were bigger than her stomach. She ordered the very, very large, which I think was Tegroot.
Tegroot.
And the person who served us was like, they're very big. And Mia was like, no, give me the biggest.
So, give me it all.
So we got the biggest chips, and about three quarters of them are still left. And that's breakfast now, I guess.
Lunch?
And yeah, we have no idea what we're doing tomorrow. We're just going to get ourselves to bed soon and find out what happens tomorrow when you've been bruged out. We thought we might spend multiple days in the city, but we've decided there's no more museums that really catch our interest. The price of a few of them that did has put us off. €30 for a museum, when you can Wikipedia it, kind of.
It'd be good if you've got kids, but because we're two young adults and we are travelling, trying to be cost efficient, then yeah, it's not quite our thing. It's not tailored for us either. It's tailored for like kids and
yeah, I might
and stuff like that.
If I had to go to Bruges tomorrow, I would probably jump on a boat.
Yeah, there's some boat tours and they're about £12, and that seems pretty €12, and that seems pretty reasonable.
But myself and the bits of hair that are standing on end have decided that
some fuzz going on.
Have decided that there's probably things to do in the surrounding area of Bruges that we'll discover tomorrow over a cup of tea. For now, we're sleeping just outside Bruges. Don't tell anyone.
Why are you saying we're Bruges out? Doesn't mean that it was negative.
No, we're just knackered. We've been in Bruges all day.
We literally have been in Bruges.
It entertained us from 10 hours until 11. 10 till 9, basically.
11 hours. We've walked around. We've seen architecture. We've been to a vegan cafe. We've been everywhere. It feels, I can't even remember.
Yeah, it's been good.
We've been to loads of places.
Yeah, me even as found a scarf. We'll show you the scarf later.
It's so soft. It's the best scarf ever.
All right, good night, everyone.
TTFN.